Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good day everyone. Let me introduce myself. My name is Desi Sasdieta and I'm from Universitas Negeri Jakarta. I would like to present our paper entitled Screening and Isolation of Indigenous Cellulolytic and Proteolytic Yeast from Fermented Dried Coca Beans. This is our outline of this presentation. First, introduction, and then research methodology, and then result and discussion. And last one is conclusion. First, introduction. Cocoa beans fermentation is a process by which large molecules are broken down into simpler molecules with the assistance of microorganisms. These are one of the microorganisms that mainly responsible in cocoa beans fermentation. They degrade pulp and produce ethanol from glucose under an aerobic and acidic conditions. Yeast has been known to have a lot of potential, such as the potential to manufacture cellulose and protease enzyme. Cellulose is an enzyme that known to degrade cellulose into glucose. Cellulose is often used in biotechnology and industry. Protease or proteolytic enzyme hydrolyze peptide bonds. Protease are also used in the food, bioremediation, and pharmaceutical industries. And main objective of this study is to obtain and test the ability of yeast isolates from fermented Sulawesi 1 and TSH 8-5-A cocoa beans to produce cellulose and protease enzyme. And this research methodology, first yeast isolation and then yeast colony purification, screening of cellulose and screening of protease. Result and discussion. First, yeast isolation. The isolation result obtained as many as 231 yeast isolate consisting of 136 yeast isolates from chocolate variety Sulawesi 1 and 95 yeast isolate from chocolate variety TSH 858. Based on the table 1, it can be seen the yeast has grown since the fermentation has not taken place. Fermentation in 0 hours. Next, cellulose screening result. Based on the result of the screening that has been carried out, it was found that 29 isolate from chocolate variety XK and 27 isolate from chocolate variety TK were declared as producing cellulose enzyme. Which isolate were declared positive if there was a clear zone around the isolate. The formation of a clear zone around the yeast colony indicates the activity of the cellulose in enzyme the degrades the CMC medium. Talenta et al. Cite that's the size of the clear zone form is an early indication of the presence of the cellulose enzyme produced where the large the clear zone form, the greater the possibility of the cellulose produce of or having high enzyme activity. The formation of clear zone shows that the cellulose in the medium is hydrolyzed by the cellulose enzyme into a simpler compound, namely cellobiose, which is then converted into two glucose molecule. Yes, more at all sites that yeast can decompose cellulose compound and form a clear zone on CMC medium to the process of breaking the glycoside bound in CMC medium by the activity of the cellulose enzyme produced by the yeast. Okay, next, protease screening result. The proteolytic activity assay was carried out using skim milk media. The result of the qualitative test is so that 3 isolates from chocolate variety SK were proteolytic yeast because they were able to produce protease enzyme, which were characterized by the formation of chiasson around the yeast colonized in figure. The presence of chiasson that appear indicate the breakdown of protein molecules contained in skim milk in the media. Proteolytic yeast are able to produce extracellular protease enzyme, which are protein breaking enzyme that are produced inside the cell and then released out of the cell. Skim milk contain casein, which function as an enzyme substrate. Hydrolysis of casein was used to show hydrolytic activity of the protease enzyme. Based on the result of the test, it was discovered that isolate from Sulawesi 1 in BDNE had the ability to produce cellulose and protease. These 3 isolates were isolated after 7 to 8 hours of fermentation. Conclusion. And in conclusion, Sulawesi 1 contained 135 yeast isolate known to be capable of producing 29 cellulose enzyme and 3 isolates that have the potential to produce protease enzyme. In TSH858, 27 of 95 isolates were known to be capable of producing cellulose enzyme and none were capable of producing protease enzyme. 3 yeast isolates that were obtained from Sulawesi 1 are capable to produce cellulose and protease. That's all from our presentation. Thank you so much for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.